Hey everyone, it's Ted Hardy with Immersion Freediving. So I wanted to make some announcements about some changes that I'm making to my courses that I'll be doing this year. So to start off, I'm gonna be doing 6 of my Freediver courses, right? Level 1 PFI Freediver programs. And I'll be doing one a month to start with. It'll be one a month, stop Bob. One a month from May to October. So that has normally in the past been a 3-day program, but I am making it 4-day program now, right? So now that course is going to be even more thorough, more comprehensive, and I'm adding some, what I think, some pretty cool stuff to it. So first off, one of the things that I'm going to be doing is normally the course is over on Sunday. I run my courses from May until October and not year round because that's just, you know, statistically when the wind speeds are the least or the less and you get the best ocean conditions, calm, blue, all that sort of stuff. So that's why I run that time. But what I'm gonna do is, normally everyone goes on Sunday, but now the course is gonna go to Monday. And if we missed a session on Saturday or Sunday, doesn't matter. I got a caption book on Monday. We can just go right back out Monday and get things all sorted. All right, so you got that going. Now, if we don't miss any sessions due to weather, which is the typical what would happen, I'm gonna be doing a optional, if they want to do it, a spear gun training session, right? So the idea is we would go to the boat, we go through a full stretching session that I normally only do in my intermediate or advanced program. So we'll go through all of that stuff, right? Before we get on the boat, right? All the stretches, all the things that I do as a free diver, competitive free diver to increase my performance. In your case, will be increasing your performance. We'll go out. And then we're gonna be working on how to integrate what you learned in my class, right? So you got this great entry, right? And you're doing everything, you're all perfectly streamlined, I'm all excited, but you're a spear fisherman. And you're like, well, how the hell am I supposed to take this big gigantic spear gun that I have and make that work with what you told me, right? So this kind of, I used to do these spear gun training sessions, but it was years and years ago. But I had a student, Angie Anderson, who's spear fishing woman. And she took the course, intermediate course, she killed it. She went home, she was like, I got back in my dirty water in the west coast of Florida, the viz was bad, and I picked up the spear gun and I started doing everything exactly like I did before I took this class. And she's like, I did not just pay $1,000 and fly down here and hotel and all this stuff to just come back and like do everything that I was doing before. So she had to figure out how to work that together to make it so that she was integrating what she learned in my class, what she was doing with spear fishing. So my point is, this is what's up, Richard? This is what I'm gonna be doing to help remedy that. I mean, most of my customers are spear fishermen, right? And freediving classes are taught without spear guns, right? For good reasons. So what I'm gonna be doing is a good buddy of mine, Jeremy Gamble, the owner of Spearing Magazine, I've been working on, and it's not released yet, but it'll be a course teaching, because he's taken my program, he does the immersion entry, right? He does awesome, super good entry. But obviously he has a very specific way that he combines it with the spear gun. And it was actually way better than what I was doing. Anyway, so his is way better. And so what I'm gonna be doing is teaching his method, right? So we've got video of him, we've got him going through and explaining why he does it this way, you know, the pros and the cons, all that sort of stuff. And then I'll get the spear fishing students learning how to integrate the spear gun with what we're doing, right? So I know when I used to run these sessions, the spear fishing guys loved it, right? Because I think that's kind of a something that I know in my classes I've never really addressed. I mean, I talk about it, but I think this will be a really good addition for spearfishing. Now, understand, this is not how to spearfishing, right? We're not gonna be spearfishing. It's just taking this one aspect, how to do the entry, right? And be streamlined, combine what you've learned with the course with me or on the days before to what a lot of my students are doing, which is spearfishing. Now, if you're not a spearfisherman, then just come out diving on the line for an extra day, right? I mean, so, you know, or not come, whatever you want. But so that third session, that spear gun training session is gonna be optional. Okay, so that's a big change that I'm doing. Basically, the course is a day longer now, right? And we're getting that extra ocean session. Okay, but there's more stuff that I'm gonna be adding. You may or may not know that I have a lot of online freediving courses, right? So when you sign up for the class, you're gonna get the freediving safety, right? Which is a free course, but it's important because a lot of my students are spear fishermen and they sign up for a course 6 months before they're gonna take it, right? I don't want them to have to wait 6 months to learn how to be safe and not kill themselves. Like, I want them to have that information right when they sign up. So freedivingsafety.com, free course, goes over all of the information that you would get in my in-person course when it comes to safety, right? So you're going to get that right off the bat. So it's important that you start learning how to be safe immediately. You don't have to wait possibly 6 months. Okay, so you're getting that. You're going to get access to my equalizing program, right? So a lot of beginning free divers and spear fishermen struggle with their ears and they get stuck around 15, 30 feet, right? There's a lot of people that take free diving classes that get stuck around 15 to 30 feet, right? And it's because of this very specific equalizing issue. There's these, I don't want to get into the whole details, but there's two main methods of equalizing. One is Valsalva, one is Frenzel. If you're struggling to equalize your ears in 15, 30 feet, it's because you're doing Valsalva most likely and you'd be doing Frenzel. So anyway, I have a course that teaches that, right? I sell that for $69. My students are gonna get that course for free, right? I've got another program called Breath Hold Secrets, teaches how to improve your breath hold, right? I charge $49 for that. My students get it for free, right? The coolest program that I have is my 28-day freediving transformation, which goes over the 5 best dry land training exercises that I know of that you can do at home, right? And that's normally $125. My students get it for free. So they get over $225 worth of online courses that I sell that the students would get for free, right? And one of the reasons I want them to go through all of that stuff is I want them to get the most out of their program when they get to me, right? Guess what? If you already know how to Frenzel before you come to your class, if you've been doing diaphragm stretches, right? If you've been doing breath holding exercises on the couch, guess what? You're gonna do better in your course. I guarantee you will, right? So I'm gonna give that to them, right? So that they do better when they come to me, right? So I'm excited to be doing all of that. So if you look at what the course is, they're gonna be getting about 3.5 hours of online education beforehand. Now, when you sign up for a course, you can't sign up for a course with me without checking a lot of boxes. And those boxes, you're going to be agreeing to a lot of stuff. And I make it very clear that you have to read the things, watch the videos, this, that, and the other. One of the things they're going to be agreeing to is they understand they have to watch all of those online videos. And it says in the sign up, 3.5 hours. And that you understand that you will watch all of those videos and that you understand that it's required before you come to class. I have the ability to go in your account and look if you watched it, if you fast-forwarded, if you skipped it, if you didn't watch it, and I will be doing that, right? And if you show up to class and you haven't completed all that, bye-bye, right? No class, no refund. You gotta go through and do the work, right? If you're gonna come take a course with me, I wanna do everything I can to make you as good as possible, but it also requires some work, right? So you're gonna have to commit to doing that work ahead of time so you get the most of the program. But it's not a big deal because all my students are going to agree to it because there's no way you can set up one of my classes without agreeing to that. So I'm excited to start implementing that because that just means my students are going to come to me even better prepared. For instance, last year, I created freedivingsafety.com and I wasn't requiring that my students watch it, which is stupid. I made the dang thing. I've got instructors out there, freediving instructors, that are requiring their students go through that program and bring proof that they passed the quiz. I'm like, how is it there are other instructors that are requiring their students to do this? I'm not. I'm the one that made the dang thing. So I'm excited to see what happens when I make my students go through more of this work ahead of time so they come to be better prepared. So I'm excited for that. This is all for my level one program, right? So they've got about 3.5 hours of stuff they're gonna have to do, right? We do 2 pool sessions, right? And then now we're gonna be doing 2 ocean sessions, and then possibly that spear gun training session is optional if they want to do that. So it would be 3, right? So I've been teaching for a long time, and I firmly believe a very simple phrase. If you follow me, you heard me say it before a lot: more time equals better results. I absolutely believe that the more time I work with the students, the more time I spend with them, with more pool sessions, more all that stuff, that I'm going to get a better product out of them. They're going to be better. They're going to learn better. So that's why I'm doing that, and I'm excited now to be adding so much new stuff to my courses. So I'm excited to get that started this year. So the course will be $850 or $849, and that'll be for the course fees and the 2 ocean sessions. If they want to do that additional spear gun training session, that's $149. That's additional and it's optional. You don't have to do it. If you don't want to do it, you don't have to. So that's how that's going to work. Now, if you want to be, those courses are not listed on the website yet. I've been doing a lot of work on my website in the past week or two. If you go look at it, you'll see there's a lot of updates to it. It's got about more of the stuff that I'm actually doing now. But I'm gonna be putting those dates up either by the end of this week or next week at the absolute latest. So what everyone's going to want to know is they want to know how can I, well, they want to know, like, can I sign up now? You can't sign up for, you can't hold a spot or anything. It's not fair to all the people that are on the email list. So if you want to be notified this second I put those courses online, if you've already signed up for my newsletter, you get the newsletter, then you're going to be notified. If you're not, or if you're not sure, what I would recommend is the best way is just go to freedivingsafety.com. Go to freedivingsafety.com, sign up for the course, go through the course so you can learn how to not kill yourself, right? Learn all the safety stuff. You're learning all the safety stuff. You're learning what a blackout looks like, what a loss of motor control looks like, how to rescue someone from a blackout, how to tell if you're overweight and all this stuff, right? Super, super thorough course. And you're going to be emailed as soon as I post the courses, right? So that way you don't feel like you have to go to my website all the time and check what's this guy doing and when are his courses up, right? So best way to be notified when I post those courses is go to freedivingsafety.com. Now, other thing that I'm really excited about is I already was going on about freedivingsafety.com. That's my new pride and joy. I've had almost 1,500 people go through that program since I launched it, which is super excited. My goal for it next year, right, 365 days from now, is 10,000, right? So I want to get a lot of people through that program. And here's why I'm so excited about it. I've had people, I know one case in particular, a spear fisherman saved some guy's life from going through the program. He was a spear fisherman. He hadn't taken a freediving course. He went out spear fishing with his buddy. He recognized underwater blackout. He saw the release of air. He knew what that meant, and he knew what to do, and he was able to save the guy's life, right? And if that's not what I and all the other freediving instructors out there promoting safety are doing, I mean, that's what we try to do, right? So I'm super excited about the program, how successful it is. I've had a lot of instructors use it as part of their pre-training. They swear by it. They stand on it. I've had, I think the last time I looked, it was 65% of the students said that, if of the people that had taken a freediving class and got their freediving safety, 65%, I think it was 62 or 65%, said they learned more in that freediving safety program, the online program, than they did in their freediving course. So what I'm getting at is this is a good quality program, and I think the whole sport would be benefited if we can get more people that's going to be participating in the sport going through some sort of safety program. Now, to be clear, this program is not a substitute for a class. In fact, the whole point of that course is I'm saying, like, you got like this much information, now go take a real class, right? And so I can also tell you from the percentages is it makes people want to go take a real course, right? So I'm trying to support that. So one of the things that I'm gonna be doing that goes along with that message is I'm gonna be doing free pool sessions in Fort Lauderdale, where you're going to, the students are gonna have to have gone through freedivingsafety.com. They're gonna have to take a screenshot. They made 100% on the quiz, right? And then they're going to come in and then they're going to practice the rescues in person, right? So now we've got something better than like, yeah, I watched the videos and that was cool and I learned how to do it. Now I got to go for free and this guy's going to actually put me through the rescue scenarios just like I would with my students, right? So you're going to start very simple, you know, dealing with loss of motor controls, and you're going to be adding, you know, what to do if someone has a blackout, what to do if someone's non-responsive, what if they're not breathing, all these things, right? What if someone has a blackout underwater, right? And so you're going to be tested in the same way that I would use do one of my students, right? What's up, Jay? So I'm really excited. It's going to be free, right? So I'll probably do maximum of 10 people. And so my first focus is gonna get these courses on the website. And once I get that all sorted up, the next thing will be to start putting dates for these free pool sessions, right? So I'm really excited about that. What I will tell you is if you are a business owner, if you work in the freediving industry, you work in the spearfishing industry, or manufacturer, or whatever, or if you're just a freediver or spearfisherman watching this video, what's up, Kevin? If you're a business owner, if you're interested in supporting this, freedivingsafety.com, reach out to me. I'm looking to figure out how to partner with other businesses to let more people know about this free resource to help, you know, get more people involved in the sport and to do so safely. All right. So if you have any suggestions, send me a message. If you're a business owner and you are interested in doing something like that, reach out to me, right? If you're watching this video and you know about freedivingsafety.com and your buddy's with someone that runs a freediving business or something and would be interested, or instructor or whatever, tag him in the thing or tell him about me and have him reach out to me, him or her reach out to me. But yeah, some other things I'm working on is I think I filmed it last year, but I haven't released it because I'm just lazy and I get busy doing stuff, is I created a course on intermediate equalizing issues. So this is a course for people who are struggling to equalize between 60 and 100 feet, right? So my roadmap to Frenzel, my basic equalizing program, I don't like to call it basic, but for people that are struggling in the shallows, 15 to 30 feet, this is a whole other thing. Right? This would be for people who are struggling to equalize between 60 and 100 feet. When I teach the intermediate class, there are tons of students that struggle to equalize around 80 feet, right? So I know exactly why they're having that problem. It's an air management issue. They don't even know what air management is, and they don't know how to do it. So I've got a course already filmed. It's already done. Yeah, it's good to see you too, Kevin. Good to come out of hibernation, right? I have a course filmed for that. I may have to refilm it because, as you just saw, I tend to talk really fast, and some people are like, "Yeah, it's really good, but you tend to talk fast." So I don't know if I'm going to be lazy and just release it like that with the talk too fast, or just put it out there to get it out there. So anyway, that's the one I've been working on. But so that's going to be kind of my plan for the next couple of weeks. As far as other courses, this is going to be, when this goes out, it'll be 6 courses. Again, it'll be one of the level 1 programs once a month in May to October. And I certainly would imagine I'll be doing more courses. I just wanted to get this first out. I then want to start doing these pool sessions, see how much interest they are in them. I mean, if these things go crazy, I might just do these on the weekends. I don't know. So I'm not sure what I'm going to be doing. I'm not initially releasing any other programs than those level 1. So that means I'm not putting up a level 2 on there. I may do that later when I get a feel for how these courses go and the pool sessions go. But so I may be doing, I absolutely imagine I'll be doing more courses. I just don't know what that is. I don't want to fill up my calendar and then wish I'd done something else, right? So that's why I'm just doing this first kind of small release of courses, right? So it'll be 6 courses once a month from May to October. If you want to be notified via email, if you're on the newsletter, you will be. If not, go to freedivingsafety.com and sign up. I wouldn't see why that would be. Did anyone else have the audio cut out? Yeah. All right, so last thing is I'll put a link in the video to where you can go to my online courses, but for if any other interested in those programs that I was talking about, Breath Hold Secrets, you learn how to hold your breath longer, you got equalizing problems, the equalizing program, if you wanna learn the training, how to train at home, right? The 5 best effective dry land training exercises that I know of, the 28-day freediving transformation program. All of those I'll give 15% off until Friday. This Friday at midnight, and the coupon code will be I saw video, meaning like you watch this video, I saw a video. You can put that in when you check out, and that'll give you 15% off. As soon as I stop this thing, I'm gonna put a link to where you can look at those online classes, but I hope to see some of you guys this year, whether it be in the free pool sessions or in the program, the full program, all right? Thanks.